This program is rated universal. Good for general watching.
Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Well, it's a two-point battle at the top of the Uganda Premier League yesterday. Vipers dropping 2 points. That was a very interesting game. But certainly for KCCA, they are back in the conversation for the league title this particular season. But tell you what, there's action today. And arguably, the biggest traditional derby, that is AC Villa. Yes, they'll be up against the club side, that is Express. Also on the show today, we'll be talking the FIFA Under 20 girls. There's a bit of football to look out for as the EFL Cup semi-finals do get to return. And it's the Manchester derby. Manchester United will take on Manchester City. A 3-1 loss from the first leg. Can they overturn that? That will certainly be the big challenge for Legana Solskjaer and his boys. But last night, Aston Villa booking themselves a place at the Wembley for the EFL Cup finals. And this evening, West Ham will be welcoming Liverpool. It's the game in hand that they have when it comes to the English Premier League. But elsewhere, there's a bit of tennis as well. Roger Federer up against Novak Djokovic. That is the semi-finals of the Australian Open. And as we do speak right now, Rafael Nadal is playing his quarter-final against the Frenchman, that is Dominic Thiem. So hey, that and so much more up ahead on the show. I welcome aboard, you're watching Game On. It's a Wednesday, and certainly we're closing down the month of January. I will probably part by 1xBet. My name is Brian Asimwe. Do remember, I'll be joined by Sharon. That is Dong for the next 1 hour, and we'll be having quite the interesting conversation. Plus, on the show, we've got a guest. Her name is Olivia, that is Nakate, and she happens to be a reporter from the New Vision. She'll be talking to us about netball, the under-21 netball side, that is the Sheepals. I've got a big tournament up ahead, so she'll give us all the lowdown and the details when it comes to that. So hey, welcome to the show. Do remember, the Harvest Man Expo is happening between the 14th and the 5th, the 16th and of February, down at the Mandela National Stadium in Nambole. Interest is 20,000, and then 10,000 that doesn't come with training. So it's probably paired with New Vision alongside the the embassy of the Netherlands. So come through, get to polish up your skills and learn a thing or two when it comes to agriculture. But hey, that being said, Saturday I'll start with Sharon. Looking quite good clad in the jersey.
Yes, of course, you know, it's a big day for us. You know, as much as you're a journalist, sports journalist, but at the same time, it's always good to tell people to know who you are exactly. I normally borrow an example from the FIFA president. He's a president, but at the same time, he's a Villa fan. So I am a sports journalist myself, but I am proud to say I'm a Villa fan. But for here today, you will even be shocked about my prediction.
We hope you have a very objective analysis, though, because
is why I'm telling you, given the statistics and what is going on between the two clubs right now, you'll be shocked by what I am going to give you as my offer.
Okay, certainly, Olivia, welcome to the show.
First
time on Game On?
No.
Yeah. You've been here before.
Second time. Yeah.
And certainly, how is the New Vision?
They're doing well.
Yeah. Okay. Are the under 21 netball girls, the Sheepals?
Yeah.
They get ready for the World Cup qualifiers.
Yes.
Give us a bit of heads up about that.
Okay. The World Cup qualifiers are set for May 4th to 10th. We're hosting the event. I think it's our first time to host this big event. Over 10 countries will be taking part, but then we began training earlier, but then we're still in a break because our kids went back to school. You know, some of them are in senior six and some are senior six, but others are soon joining the university. So we started training earlier so that maybe we can prepare our girls mentally and physically for this big tournament.
Yeah.
But we have made some, I think they have made some adjustment. One I can maybe give out is they have selected the team basing on height compared to other teams. They have been selecting our previous teams. Our shooters are really, really good. So many of them are still young, but then they have some good height, which I think it will be good if they, maybe they will be good sitting in, Sheep Queen's fates. But we have also, we have on board our UK-based player, that's Melissa Elem.
Okay.
She's 16, she joined the team last week, but the height is promising, the skills, you know, the way UK plays their netball is totally different from ours, so we think she'll use her skills maybe to improve on our girls.
Okay, Olivia, before I get come back to you, Sharon, initially there was a squad of about 40 players that were summoned. That was reduced to about 27. Ultimately, we expect about 12 to make the final cut. Ultimately, everyone will be hoping, can we have a team that walk into the footsteps of the Sheikh Cranes, who have been fantastic, 3 World Cups, and set the bar when it comes to sports?
Yes, 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 because we still have the same management. The management of the Federation has not changed at all. The same management that works so hard to see the senior Sheikh Cranes perform so well at the international scene is the same which is still there. Madame Susan Aneka, regardless of all the negative pundits on her, for me, I think I still give credit to her, because ever since the revival of netball in Uganda, she's spectacular, one of the best presidents of the FAs, I mean, of the Federation in the country. Two, I think preparation has been done in time, this time around. It is not something that has been bumped all of a sudden, but the girls coming at the point where we have just appointed a new minister in charge of sports, and who has also been following netball so much, by the Honorable Hamson Oboa. So this time round, I don't even actually expect anything related to financial constraints disturbing the camp a lot, given the fact that, first of all, you know, if these issues, you can never take away the fact that there's what we call in Uganda on Owafe, you know, Aneka and Oboa share a lot in common. So you expect that the girls are going to be good, because you need a lot of motivation in the camp. What motivates players is basically how you keep them in check, facilitate them, feed them. Unlike in the senior team, when they were qualifying for World Cup, you'd hear stories where feeding was a problem. They would feed at prisons. The same round, you've not had such stories. So for me, yes, it's a very big yes for me.
Okay, Olivia, head coach Rashid Mubiru says the girls will also be assessed going by the school's competitions. Tell us about the criteria of choosing some of the players.
Of course, these girls were selected according to the way how they used to play in their schools. So they selected the best ones. Of course, I've been watching these girls in these school tournaments, but I can tell you they are selected the best ones. They're the ones who made it on the team.
What are some of the key things that are going to be worked on during the training sessions before the qualifiers in Fiji?
I think our defense needs to be worked upon, because something which has been disturbing the Sheikh Cranes also is the defense, because when Gio got an injury, you saw how we suffered.
Yeah.
But this time around, they're working on the defense and then the shooting side.
And for the fans,
maybe
out
should
there,
tell us someone who, some of those notable key players you think are going to help us so much in the defense.
I think when you look, there's a girl from Budo, she's called Christine. Yeah, Christine. She's good in the defense. And then on the shooting side, I told you about Melissa.
Yeah.
She's really good. And then Anisha, she's really good also.
Okay. Quickly, you know, as the conversation continues, Sharon, the senior team have made it a habit to go to the World Cup. The under-21s, most of these girls ultimately are supposed to fit into the senior team. I just think there is that continuity. Do you have a pathway where girls can go from the junior teams, come through playing schools netball, ultimately get into the senior team? And have we put things in place to make sure that we can rub it with countries like South Africa, who have become powerhouses, not just on the continent, but also across the globe?
Starting with the positive side, yes, we are seeing continuity, because the fact that we are involving these young girls to also participate at the international scene, this one is a very clear indicator that you're already exposing them at this junior stage, so that by the time they reach that stage where they're supposed to go further with the senior team, it's not going to be something you're going to start from scratch. Two, on the negative side, I don't think at the moment we can still yet compare ourselves to South Africa in terms of building our teams right from the junior category to the senior category, because one, as we all go back, remember one time when you hosted Susan Anekia, she alluded to the fact that we are getting limited funding from government through the Minister of Sports and National Council. So for you to have all these teams, the under 18, under 19, under 21, under up to the senior team, first of all, you need to have facilities, you need to have enough finance. So unless this is put in place, yes, we shall be having participation.
Okay.
But in terms of that richness you'd want to talk about on and off pitch, because for the South Africans, it's not just about on pitch, but it is even prior to the pitch.
Yeah.
So these are my two sides.
Okay, Olivia, for you that has been in camp, seen these girls training, what would you say has been the conditioning for the team, the technical contribution from the coaches, the financial contribution from the federation and the different stakeholders? What can you give us as an exclusive as this under 21 team continues preparations?
Okay, what I can say, the training has been a little not so much serious, maybe to the maximum, but they have been a little bit serious. Mm. And then the girls, warfare, not all that bad. Mm. Financial, not all that bad.
Yeah,
yeah, what I can tell you, they're still in a good mood. Mm. Yeah.
So should we fancy our chances of getting into the under 21 Netball World Cup?
Of course we are, because this is not our first time to be part in the Netball World Cup. We took part in 2017, so yeah, we still can make it.
What are some of the strengths you think this team has got?
As I told you our shooting is really good. We have trained our girls, we have the height, and then our defense. That will be our strength, I think, come this one.
Do you take those girls, do they take those girls once in a while to the gym also to build? Do you know why I'm asking this question? When I watched the World Cup, I saw the Zambians, and then I saw even the English ladies. The girls looked mugged, they looked so strong, and you would really see their energy on the pitch. It meant that it was not just about feeding and all, not just about training. Do we have such training sessions where you take them probably for gym and giving them that energizing?
Uganda Pro Federation adopted up that policy, I think, at Fitness for Life Gym with the Shukrens. I hope they adopted the same policy when it comes to the Sheep House.
Okay, we've got to wrap up this conversation. Fast running out of time, Olivia. But as we get to go, for the viewers out there, any parting shot, any last words you want to leave them with, especially for the fans of netball that are rooting for the under 21s that are quite passionate for the sport?
Yeah, our team is promising, and I hope we'll be back in the Youth World Cup the second time. So we should expect the best since we are the host this time around.
Okay.
The fan base should be.
That's it now in Lugogo.
Yeah.
Okay. There you go. That is certainly Olivia Nakate. She's a netball reporter from the New Vision. She gave us a bit of exclusives about the under 21 netball girls. That is the Sheep House, as they get ready for the under 21 netball World Cup qualifiers. But that being said, we're going to step into a break. When you come back after the break, there's a bit of volleyball. There has been a training camp for the last couple of days to pretty much scout talent and then also train them here and there. So we'll be discussing that, including all the action from last night or last evening when it came down to the Uganda Premier League. Big win for KCCA, certainly a big win for Proline as well, as they climb from the bottom of the Uganda Premier League standings. But elsewhere for Vipers, they've got all the work to do because KCCA have now closed the gap to just 2 points. And as it is right now, the big derby down in Bombo at the Barracks grounds as AC Villa do certainly take on Express. Plus, later on, there's tennis and plenty of football to look ahead to. So stick around that and so much more after the break. You're watching Game On. We're probably powered by 1xBet.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports.
Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.